This is a 3D embossing folder of the month, tiled motif. See, this is what it looks like. So if you put this in here, I guess. Let's see, it's 3D actually, so it's a platform base with this, and then the adapter plate, so not the D. Let's see if this is red. Did it work? And it did. Well, that's pretty. Would you look at that? That'd be a very nice. Cut it in half. Nice card panel. Like a background kind of thing. Just like emboss and deboss on the back. That's pretty. So why don't we do another one? Let's see. Let's see. So we did this one already. Next, should we do another boss? Embossing one? So these were Spellbinders, so I was tempted to do a not Spellbinders one. See what that looks like. Well, we did a 3D, so should we do a 2D? A normal 2D embossing folder? And again, there is also we'll do that with the other one, playing question. So there is a detailed embossing folder, flowers and leaves. That's what's about Spellbinders. Or there's this one, which I got from the magazine. Hmm. go for this one. And then again, there's also another one that's very pretty as well, which is a rose one. Or we could actually, it's a diamond rectangle. You know, this one always reminds me of like that Friends frame right there. So there's that, and that's a 3D one. The other one's a 3D one. The rose one is a 2D. We'll go for the other. We'll go for this one. So this sandwich will be different, I believe. I think I need to move this over more so I can fit it in. See, a normal one would be platform AB. There. So it's platform AB, embossing folder, then cutting part. So. Embossing folder and staple. I did not yet take it off. And of course, tape wants to stick on the back, doesn't it? And heating it up does help take the tape off, though it's not going very far. Heat it up some more, because the stupid tape on the back. Don't want it interfering. Side need half. Okay. Probably should have thought of this before. I can use this. Since I don't want to get out my result. Oops. I think that's my brayer. So I don't want to get out my, what's it called? A guillotine. It's over there. I don't think it's worth it. So I'll just get out my little quick trimmer. Because I got the blades here. Paper blade back in. And now I can fit this in here. Do I want the goldie up there? Oh, there's some gold down here too. Okay. It's a very clean cladding plate, isn't it? Anyway. Lined up. So well, sort of. It's not very thick. If you want a very, very faint. Let's see if I can put it in again. That wasn't enough. Wasn't if I know, let's put that there for a sec. Well, let's put this in and see what happens. Oops. Probably totally unnecessary, but let's see if it does anything with just adapter. Oops. I got the one on the bottom. Don't think that did it. Or 2Ds are just not supposed to be very thick, like defined. Let's try this. That's more defined now, anyway. That's better. Very nice. I think it'd look more defined on darker cardstock, maybe? Who knows, really? So that's that one. Should I go back to the 3D one? Because it actually looks like it shows anything. So it's just put this back in here. So that was this one. What next? We need to try and cut something, right? So let's just AB cutting plate cardstock combo. Thank you. Okay, so the main reason I got this was to put on here. So, if you want to cut downwards, then that would be the thing. So, I need a die, which I put over there. So I guess we can... we'll use something. Okay. At least we got two lovely looking things here. I need to rewash my hands. Glitter everywhere. So, move this out of the way. Whoops. Put the embossing folder back. I guess I could put this one in there. Okay, so should we use? So you know what? I actually stamped this ages ago, as you know, in as you probably know, ages ago, from previous today, I stamped this quite a while ago, and I put it in here. I feel like I did. Where did the bunny go? I lost it already. Cut something else. And then I didn't stamp. That doesn't need one. I could do flat. Something from green and blue. Think about we'll use that one. and drop it to the left and right. We'll do that. Do those two. And that's too small. Here, yeah, go like that. Should I do something else too? I don't really want to waste space. What do I do?
let's see what it looks like, shall we? If this will just stay in one place. Do I need to do it again? Maybe another time. Just to make sure. I see the tape. Some takes off a little bit of some like powder. Low tack, not quite as low tack as I hoped. Well. Well, I thought it was going to come out anyway.
That's perfect. I'm gonna use that. I guess I got a plan. Let's see if this worked. A little bit. It may protect the cutting plates, but it makes it, you know, not cut as deep. So I guess try again. It is, you know, I'm quite as cut as almost the eye went on that one. Hmm. have done stuff with their hand, but there's the fairy. You get better scissors. Anyway. Oops. Probably shouldn't. Here's some purple tool. me try it with thinner cardstock. Those are good for embossing. I'm not sure if those are good for cutting. Let's try this. Let's try this. Let's try that. I might need a ship for this. Maybe. So try it this way. just one slight thing on that one. So not as bad as the other time. That one just came right off. Oh, the stone I want is a yeah, that's another one. That sounds better. I guess this was thin enough. But not thin enough to cut out our legs though. Yep, missed a foot. Anyway. At least she came out. Her wand not so much though. Cut her wand off. Oh, that's pretty good.
Not quite. Doesn't seem to be cutting very well though. But I for some reason have something like this. I'm not sure if I have a ball. Well, for argument's sake, let's very nice. Arguments. Let's see how it does without the cutting mat. Because otherwise, I'll have to think of. I'll need to think of what else I need to put in with this. First of all, I am doing the right sandwich, aren't I? A, B, cutting plate, paper,
Let's compare how they do. Oh, I might as well. Obviously, the flowers automatically are out. The part was good. And the fairy came out nicely. I put that the opposite way. Well, of course I did, didn't I? Dragon jelly. I can't believe I put it the opposite way. I got well, it looks nice, but I can't believe I gotten. Oh, come on. Okay. did it, which is great. Let's see. So I did it on the thinner cardstock. Let's see if it'll work on this one. Like that. Still a couple. That many shims. 1, 2, 3, 4. It still had. Maybe it might not need all of the shims.
not quite there yet. However, if I put it on here instead. Very pretty. Lots of things stuck in it though.
Let me try this first. Yeah, that's better.
I've got a lot of paper to vacuum up, so, it's a bit messy. You don't really need to go over it twice, because it kind of, kind of messed up that bit, but it does make a nice effect when you go over it twice, but that's when you go over it once. You don't have a thing. But still, that's pretty nice. I'll keep those bits as well. But anyway, yes, so I've embossed and cut with a 2D and a 3D embossing folder. How to emboss the cut shape? Okay, I got it. I guess I can use this. Okay. Paper and cutting die, cut side up. Well, I'm just gonna do a little bit. I can't do that one. I need to do the smaller one. This is the paper size I got left. Might as well just do this. I need embossing and an adapter plate. Thank you.
Okay. There we go. But I think I could probably still emboss it with the cutting mat because that's not really cutting much of anything. And I think mostly all the sandwiches. See, embossing holder, 3D embossing holder, cut shape, cutting die. Yep, I did all the sandwiches, I believe. So yeah, I guess this is like, I guess I'll put this at the, after the opening of this. It's been a while since I actually recorded that, so it's, yeah. Yeah, I'll just say this is part of the, gonna be a long opening and crafty video. I'll cut off a lot of the of me faffing around, but yeah, that's a lot of flower bits. Yes. So, thank you for watching. Like, subscribe for more. Ring the doorbell for notifications. And I guess I'll put the if there is a link, if it's still available, or at least I'll tell you the people I bought it from and their main store website. The things I used in this. Yeah, which is the one from the fairy set, the one from the heart, which is a lawn flower, the flower one, which was the same, not the same series as the fairy one, I think. That was the Once Upon a Time series. That one was like the countryside one, or Belle countryside or something? I don't know. And obviously the snowflake one was the snowflake nesting die one. What was I thinking of you for? I think that was on its own, but it was one from something. Anyway, most of those were Crafter's Companion, except for the little heart that was from Lawn Phone. And most, and see, one of the this one was from Spellbinders, and this one was from Stamp and Creative magazine. But yeah, that's that. But yeah, it's very messy, so I need to clean up. So thank you for watching. I sent that already. Over and out then.